In this demonstration, I will show how to configure the hidden data role to link to external URLs and how to use a hidden data role to configure a data source mapping for a page link. Let's take a look at the hidden data role. The hidden data role accepts one or more category or date data items. The exception is only the list table can accept measure data items. The hidden data role includes the data item in the query results, but it will not be displayed on the object. A hidden data role cannot be used as both hidden and a data tip value. A hidden data role data item is available for use in color map display rules, external links, and mapping data sources. The hidden data role is not available for all types of objects. Let's go ahead and get into the demonstration for the hidden data role. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 8.5, but this feature is available for SAS Visual Analytics 8.2 and above. I'm going to go ahead and toggle over to a report I've already started, but not yet configured the hidden data role. Let's dive in. First, let's take a moment to look at my data. I've captured the Super Bowl winner information for the last 54 Super Bowls. Toggling over to the Super Bowl winner data page, you can see I have the year. I also have the Super Bowl number, not included in this particular list table. I have winning city, winning team, losing city and team, the high score for the game, low score for the game. And then I have two URLs in this data set. I have the winning team site URLs and then the individual Super Bowl websites. When linking out to an external URL, this is not something that you always want displayed with your results. This is when the hidden data role can really come into play. So let's go ahead and toggle back to the first page of the report, and we're going to configure this list table to link out to the winning team's website. So let's go ahead and switch over and expand our roles. And here we have our hidden data role. When I go ahead and add the winning team site, we can see we have 20 unique winning team sites. When I include that data item in the results for the list table, you can see that my aggregation doesn't change. I have 20 unique winning city and team sites, and I have a total of 54 Super Bowls played. When I change the hidden data role to the individual Super Bowl websites, which is 54, you can see that the aggregation of the data, because this data item is included in the results for this object, you can see that the aggregation is not possible because of the uniqueness of the Super Bowl websites. We still see we have a total of 54 Super Bowls that had been played, but this is not the aggregation of how I want to see the list table. So I'm going to go ahead and toggle back to this, our winning team site, just emphasizing that the hidden data role, truly this data object is returned with the result set for that particular object. Let's go ahead now and configure the external URL. Using our actions pane, we're going to go to our URL links and click plus for the new URL link. I'm going to name it winning team site. And then for my parameters, the source is going to be that winning team site in the data. Notice that I only have these three available data items because this is what has been assigned to the list table. I'll go ahead and select winning team site and click OK. And now when I double click on one of the row items, it takes me out to that linked URL. Okay. Next, let's take a look at using the hidden data role as a data source mapping to a second data source. I'm going to go ahead and expand my data pane. So we can see I have the Super Bowl winners. I also have the Super Bowl venues information. So let me toggle over to the Super Bowl venue data page. And you can see here that I have information about the year the Super Bowl was played, the state, the city, the venue name, and then the attendance numbers. I also have the Super Bowl number that is going to serve as our hidden data role mapping. So this is just, I'll go ahead and add it so you can see it to the role. This is just the number of the Super Bowl that was played that I'm going to use somewhat as an index that we not necessarily want to be shown on the object. So you can see I've not included it in my target. So this is going to be my target report. Bring back the first page. And here I have my line chart. Looking at my line chart by year, I'm looking at the high score compared to the average high score for all the Super Bowls. And I don't have a hidden data role. So if I want to link this information, the Super Bowl winner information, over to the Super Bowl venue data, I could, of course, match on year because this is simple data, but I'm going to pretend that my Super Bowl number is more of a key that I wouldn't want obviously displayed on the line chart. So I'm going to go and add as a hidden data role the Super Bowl number and click OK. And then I'm going to configure a page link. So from my actions pane, I'm going to configure a page link to the Super Bowl venue data. And here it's telling me I need to map my data. So from there, I could do year. I'm not really going to do year. I'm going to use the Super Bowl number, as I've mentioned before. So now when I click on this, it'll take me directly to the Super Bowl venue data page. If I wanted to toggle off incoming values, I could, and then I would get the report in its entirety. But now we've used the hidden data role to link out to a different data source. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or check out one of my other videos or blogs. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.